Okay, folks, video is on. The trimethyl right here is going to tell you you've got three methyl groups on this heptene. Where are they? Well, one of them's at carbon three, another's at carbon three, and another's at carbon five. Does that make sense, folks?
Yes.
Okay. If you went the other way, the first methyl would be on carbon number three, and that matches up. So there's no difference there. But over here, you can see that we've got two methyl groups on carbon 5 if we're doing the blue numbering. So that would be 3,5,5 trimethyl. Well, the threes match up, so that's the same. And then we go on to the next one, and this is the first point of difference. So here we have a 3 and here we have a 5. We don't even have to worry about the next ones because that's the first point of difference. So IUPAC says we're going to go ahead and go with the pink numbering because it keeps the numbers as low as possible at the first point of difference. Okie dokie, Smokies?
Yes.
Okay, questions for me? Concerns? Yes.
So for numbering the elements, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 from left to right, but then underneath we go right to left. I thought we'd keep it with 1.
So it was just showing you the incorrect version. So it was showing you the possibilities for numbering this chain. So you have a 7-carbon chain, parent chain either way. And it was saying that you choose the pink numbering because the number right here, 3, is smaller than the number right here, 5. Okay, does that make sense?
Yes.
Anybody else? Okay, moving on. So after that, number 9 says, go ahead and cite your substituents. And remember, substituents, that's the same thing as a branch in alphabetical order, regardless of location. Now, what our brains are going to want to do is our brains are going to want to put the lowest number first because IUPAC was all over, like, putting the lowest number. But then they say, okay, you're going to put the substituents in alphabetical order. methyl and ethyl, you're going to say that the ethyl comes before the methyl. And what on earth am I talking about? Well, let's take a look at the molecule at the top left. So, you guys want to number left to right or right to left?
Right to left.
Right to left, because your first branch will happen at carbon 2. And if you number from left to right, your first branch is going to happen at carbon number 3. Does that make sense, folks?
Yes.
Okay. So, we're going to number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And again, what's the H3C on the left right here? That's exactly the same as having a CH3 on the end. We just like to mix it up like that to confuse you guys, because that's so much fun, right? Yay! Okay. Anyways, so you guys can see that you've got a branch on... Okay, you've got a branch on carbon number 2 and a branch on carbon number 3. First of all, what's the parent chain called?
Heptane.
And then we have branches. So we have two what, folks? Two methyl. And what else?
Five ethyl.
And if you didn't know that one was methyl and the other one was ethyl, or know the difference, don't worry, you're learning this, and we had a chart in the slides there. So if you guys want to like print out the chart and have it sitting right next to you when you do your homework, that might work really well. Okay, now if we number the other way, just in case you tune me out. Okay, well, just in case, you know, someone's mind was wandering somewhere else, just saying it again. Okay, that would give us a 3,6. So we have a 3-ethyl, and what else, folks?
6-methyl.
So you'd have 3,6 instead of 2,5. Do you guys see that? Do you see why we did blue instead of red? Okay. Any questions on that? Why we numbered in the direction we numbered in? We're all good with that, folks? Okay. All right, so I'm gonna erase that part. So what our brains would probably want to do is say 2-methyl, 5-ethyl heptane, right, folks? Because 2 comes before 5, and that just makes sense to us, but the rule up there, number 9, says no. Ha ha ha. Even though that sounds like the way you'd want to do it, you're going to put them in alphabetical order. So go ahead and tell me what you start with. Yep, 5-ethyl. Because E comes before M in the alphabet. Ah! Right, folks? So we have 5-ethyl, and then you're going to put a hyphen between the L and the 2, because remember we have a hyphen between numbers and letters. So 5-ethyl, 2-methyl, what, folks? Heptane. Good, good, good. Questions for me?
Heptane or
heptane? Heptane, H-E-P. The one on the right up here, most of us are going to look at this and go, okay, the chain that is horizontal right there in the middle, that one looks like the longest one possible, right, folks? This one right here? Yes, no, maybe so? Okay. So then we have to choose, are we going to number it left to right or right to left? Right to left, because then we have 1, 2, 3, our first branches on the third carbon. And if we go left to right, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and we have our first branch on carbon number 4. So does it make sense that we're going to go that way?
Yeah.
Okay, awesome.
Oops, I can't. Not today. Okay, so our parent is who, folks? Okay, so give me the branches. What's that one on number two? On carbon number two of the parent chain. Go ahead, you're just screaming out.
Oh, it's
Oh, maybe I should put on my glasses. Thanks, you guys. I keep forgetting I'm old. You guys are awesome and you're paying attention.
How old is he young? Younger.
Okay, here we go. Can't do both of those. Okay, so you guys said we got an octane here. Yay. Well, that would be more exciting than heptane because we just did heptane, right? Okay, so. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, that looks good to my eyes at this point. So then we would have octane. All right, so are we good, folks?
Yes.
Okay. All right, so we have 2-ethyl. And what are our other 2 branches, folks?
3-ethyl.
So we've got a 5-methyl and a 5-methyl, and I heard some of you go ahead and say what that makes, which is a what? Yes. So then we're going to have a 5-5-dimethyl there. Okay. Are we okay with that?
Would it change the dimethyl? Oh, no. It's on the third one, right? That wouldn't change it.
What are we changing?
The 2 to the 3 from
Wow, I am just not on it today, am I, folks? All right, thank you. 3, yes, absolutely. Yes, if we change the number of the carbon in the chain, definitely the 2 would go to the 3. Okay, so we've got 3-ethyl and we have 5-5-dimethyl. And the rule underneath what I've just written, folks, says that di, tri, and tetra, and hyphenated prefixes like tersh and sec, we're going to ignore those for alphabetization rules. So who comes first, dimethyl or ethyl?
Ethyl.
So what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to put dimethyl first because we just learned that we're going to alphabetize them instead of putting them in number order. But then part of that says that you don't count the di, tri, and the tetra. So with the naming stuff, folks, what you're gonna find is it's not super hard. It's just that there's tons of these little rules that you have to remember, and it gets way easier as a semester goes on. So you'll do it over and over and over again. But I just have to warn you, it's just like the little tiny rules that kill along the way. So just do the homework and you'll get it no problem. Okay, so what are we gonna start the name with, folks?
3-ethyl.
Okay, so we're gonna do 3-ethyl. And then what? Anybody?
5-5-dimethyl.
Thank you, 5-5-dimethyl. And then what? Octane! Thank you! Anyone have any problem with that? Yes, sir.
So, I don't get confused. You said that it has to go in alphabetical order. There's going to be an exception, correct?
Yes, because it's a Greek prefix. So, what we're going with is the E versus the M rather than E versus the D because the di is one of the Greek prefixes. Okay? Everybody else okay with that? Heard a no.
No,
Oh, that was a yes. Okay, great. All right. The next thing says ISO, NEO, and Cyclo are not ignored. So just keep that in mind, and that's because they're not hyphenated. So again, if it's a Greek prefix or if it's hyphenated, like T-butyl, okay, we're going to ignore those. But things like cyclobutane or neopentane, those are not. All right, the one on the bottom. Anyone want to try that one? Nobody's brave enough. Okay. So let's take a look at how we would number this thing first. So you're looking at it, and you're like, okay, first thing I need to do, I need to look for the longest continuous chain. So maybe you're like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, that one's bigger than that one. Maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so we have a couple of 7 possibilities, right? Does anyone see 8? Okay, where's 8? Tell me. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8?
Yeah.
Does that work for us? Okay, so here's the thing. Are we gonna go C or are we gonna go like backwards C?
C.
Okay, because that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, so our 2 branches would be on carbon 4, whereas if we went the opposite direction, our 2 branches would be on carbon number what? 5, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So are we okay with why we're numbering like that, instead of like that? Okay, awesome. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, hopefully I caught all the carbons that I've got my glasses on. Now we have a couple of branches off of our 8 carbon chain, this one right here, and this one right here. So let's go ahead and do the red one first. So let's do our branches, and you don't have to write this on the side. I'm just putting down on paper, like my process and my brain just to keep track of things, okay? So that first branch right there has 3 carbons. And usually things with 3 carbons have what in the name of them? Prop, right? Like propane? Yes, no, maybe so? Okay, but this one is connected to the center carbon. So what that would look like if you were drawing it in line bond form, instead of CH3, CH3, it would look like a little snake tongue up like that. Does anyone remember what that one is called?
Isopropyl.
Good. Okay. And then that blue one is a CH2, CH3. What one? What is that called?
Ethane.
That one is from ethane, but it's a branch, so it's called ethyl. Yeah. And we saw that twice before. We saw it drawn like that, and we saw it drawn like that. So we're just drawing it in a different orientation. And our parent is what, folks?
Octane.
Our parent is octane. And then as I'm working on this, I notice, oh, I forgot to write the numbers in front of my branches like I usually do, and then I can go back and put them in. So do you guys see that I'm just like kind of writing down my thought process here? If you're like, bam, and you can write the whole name down, woohoo you, all right? No wait. Okay, all right. So the ethyl is on which carbon, folks?
4.
It's on 4, so that one is a 4 ethyl, and the isopropyl is on which carbon?
4.
So I'm gonna squish that in, that's a 4 isopropyl. So do we do I versus E? I didn't even get to ask my question yet. You're on it. Do we do I versus E or P versus? And my friend over here said, yes, we do the I versus the E. Why do we do I versus E? Because right here, it tells us, iso is not ignored. Okay, there's no hyphen between iso and propyl. And IUPAC says those are the rules. And if you want your points in this class, you gotta follow the rules, right, folks?
Yay! Okay, so who's first? Four ethyl or four isopropyl?
Four ethyl.
Because everybody in here probably has A, B, C, D, right?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, so four ethyl, and then what comes next?
Four isopropyl.
Yes, a hyphen, and then four isopropyl. And then what?
Octane.
All right, are we okay with this at this point?
Yes.
Yes, so this is gonna be on your assignment for next week's lab. Aren't you guys excited?
Very.
Very. I'm so excited. I'm going to talk in monotone. Okay, let's do some problems because you guys are just dying to do some problems here, right? Okay, am I going to number forwards or backwards on this one? Top left.
Backwards.
So my friends want to number backwards because that would mean that our first branch is on carbon 2. If we would have numbered left to right, our first carbon would be on, sorry, our first branch would be on carbon number what?
Three.
It would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we want our first branch to be on 2 rather than on the third. Okay, folks, so we've got a 2-methyl here, and we have what here?
Ethyl.
Yes, you have ethyl, and that's a 3-ethyl. So instead of writing out branches and listing them, there you go. There it is in, like, you know, poking at them format. And our parent is what?
Pentane.
Yeah, it's pentane. All right, folks, who comes first? 3-ethyl or 2-methyl?
3-ethyl.
And you're going to want to put 2-methyl first because 2 comes before 3, but IUPAC says no. You put ethyl first because E comes before M. So we're going to do 3-ethyl and then a hyphen and what? 2-methyl, thank you, folks. And then what?
Pentane.
Yes, and then no space in pentane. Questions for me? No, we're all good? All right, well, if you aren't, then you can scream at me. Anyone want to do the top right? A doggy looking thing? Whatever it looks like. Okay, so just looking at this is like, looks like something you wouldn't want to fall on. Ow! Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, or 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Looks like we're gonna get 4 continuous carbons any way we go, right, folks?
Yes.
And then either way you go, you're gonna have 2-methyls on carbon 2 and 2-methyls on carbon 3. You folks see that?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is a pretty symmetrical one. So most of us are going to want a number left or right, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I should say correct. So let's go ahead and do that. It doesn't matter which one you start with, but I'll go with that one. Okay, folks, so that parent is who? So that parent right there is butane. And what you have is you have the 4 branches and it's something that's at the end of that stick right there. So remember when we were talking about skeletal structures, we said at any point in any end you have a carbon, but the points are usually CH2s and the ends are what? CH3. So if you have this, it's telling you there's a CH3 there, 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 and there. Does that make sense to us? We're okay with that? All right, so let me draw them in just in case you missed that lecture about skeletal structures. And also, folks, you'll see it a lot of times drawn H3C
Same thing as CH3. Okay, so what we have for our branches we have 2-methyl, we have a 2-methyl, what else do we have?
3-methyl.
Yep, 3-methyl, what else?
Another
3-methyl. So we've got 4-methyl groups. So that's going to turn into what? Yeah, tetra. Where is that? That's right there. So if you got 2, it's di. If you have 3, it's tri. If you have 4, it's tetra. So because all of these are the same branch, you can put all the numbers at the front. Now, if you have 4 branches, you better have 4 numbers. You have to locate every single one of them, even if 2 of them are on the same carbon of the parent chain. Are we okay with that? Okay, so let me come on down here for a little more space. So we're going to have 2, comma 2, because remember when you have numbers next to each other, you have a comma between them, rather than the hyphen that's between the number and the letter. So we have 2, comma 2. Keep going for me, folks.
Dimethyl?
Not dimethyl. You've got 4 of them.
3-3-tetramethyl.
3-3-tetramethyl. Butane. Thank you. In the back there. 2-2-3-3-tetramethyl butane. So this is saying that you've got a 4-carbon parent chain. You have 4 methyls on there somewhere. Where are they? 2 of them are on carbon 2, 2 of them are on carbon 3. Now you're going to be really good at reading your shampoo bottles, right, friends? All those ingredients that look all big and long and have numbers in them. You're like, what on earth is that? Now you're going to be like, oh, oh. Yeah, now you're all going to be reading your shampoo bottles. Yes, sir.
I noticed that they actually changed the word for the journal. They're using a chemistry name now.
Is somebody putting cocaine in their ingredients? In something?
In another country, I actually stumbled upon one, but I noticed it's people saying it's another chemical name. I forgot the name.
Oh, okay. They use the IUPAC name for it?
Yeah.
Is it in Peru? Yeah, because I know that like for going up to Machu Picchu, like they'll give you cocaine because of the altitude and it helps the heart or whatever. Has anyone gone to Machu Picchu? Oh, I hope to.
Yeah, but I mean
not for the cocaine.
They changed it to avoiding illegal problems.
Yeah, I can imagine, yeah. Okay, folks, any questions on this? Okay, so let's take a look at the bottom left. And I'm gonna just erase this so I can have some more room. Okay, so looking at this, we gotta do our first step, which is finding the longest continuous chain. So that's gonna be our first step always. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I think we can find another one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, probably 5? Or do you guys see a longer one? Yay, someone in the middle is like 5, please can we continue? Okay, so 5 is it. And then we have to decide, well, which one are we gonna choose? Now, if we go with this one right here, it looks like we will have 1, 2, 3 branches. Do you see any other 5-carbon continuous chains that has more than 3 branches?
No.
No? Okay. So do we like this one right here?
Mm-hmm. Or the other one. Or yeah, but.
Or the bottom straight.
So if we did the bottom one, it would be 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh.
Does that make sense why we did this one instead? Okay.
So are we okay with this line right here? With that parent chain, folks?
Yes.
Okay, so the next thing we have to do is number. We have to decide whether we're going left to right or right to left. What do we want to do, folks?
Right to left.
Right to left, because we go 1, 2, and we have two branches on carbon 2. If we went this way, we go 1, 2, 3 before we hit the first branch. Are we all right with that?
Yes.
Okay. So let's number backwards on that one. Okay, so we have three of the same branches. They are all called what?
Methyl.
They're all methyl. CH3 is methyl. Therefore, we can put all the numbers together in the front, right? Yes, no, maybe so?
Yes.
Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to say 2, 2, 3. Is anyone confused by why I started with that? Okay, so you'd split the numbers up if you had different substituents, like we did up here. You see how it's 3-ethyl, 2-methyl? The ethyl and the methyl, they're different branches. But because we all have three of the same branches, you can group them all together. So we have 2, 2, 3, and then hyphen, because we've got a letter coming up next. And tell me what that is, folks. Trimethyl, yes. Common student mistake to write at that point, just put methyl, okay? So you also don't want to do 2-methyl, 2-methyl, 3-methyl, or 2,2-dimethyl, 3-methyl. If they're the same, group them together. Okay, 2, 2, 3, trimethyl what, folks? Pentane. 5 is the easy one, like pentagon. 8 is easy too. Most of us know oct, right? Okay, 2, 2, 3, trimethylpentane. Questions for me, folks?
So if it's the same group, every time group them together? Like,
yes.
If it's the same.
You got it.
Tri is 3, correct?
Yes, tri is 3. Okay, now we have a really funny looking one here. So we just start where we usually start. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, does anyone see one longer than 8?
No.
Okay, so do we want to go with 8?
Yeah.
Yay! That was a definite confident yes. Alrighty, so we're going with the parent is what?
Octane.
So again, I'm just writing down my thought process here. Okay, so the next thing we have to do is what?
Figure out what it's about.
Yeah, you have to figure out which 8 carbon chain you want to pick and then which way you want to number it. So does anyone want to choose which 8 carbon chain we go with? And don't worry about making a mistake. That's okay, you guys are learning. Mm-hmm. You guys just want to go straight left to right?
Mm-hmm.
And again, don't worry about it if, like, we have to correct ourselves. That's what happens here. I heard a few people say no. So anyone who said no about straight on left to right, what do you want to do? I promise I don't bite. Why don't we try left to right? And then let's just correct as we go. And don't worry, it's not a waste of time. Okay, so our parent chain is octane, and then we have some branches. What's this one right here? That's a methyl. So right now we've got it at 4-methyl. What about this one right here? That's propyl. So we've got CH3, CH2, CH2. And remember, do not count the carbon that's on the parent chain. So right there, 1, 2, 3. So are we okay with that? That's a propyl? Does anyone need me to draw the carbons in? Yeah? Okay, no problem.
me do it in red. Okay, do you need the hydrogens on that, or are you good there? Okay, so what we have there is a 4-propyl. And then what do we have at number 5, folks? What's that thing that looks like a T?
T-butyl.
T-butyl, or you can call it tert-butyl, but most people call it T-butyl. Okay, so we've got 4-methyl, 4-propyl, and 5-T-butyl there. Before we put the name together, can anybody see a different numbering system where we could lower the numbers? If we went backwards, 1, 2, 3, 4, we'd have a 4-T-butyl, but then we would have a 5-5 right here. So 5-methyl and 5-propyl. So it'd probably be better to have 4-4-5 than 4-5-5, right, folks?
Yeah.
Okay, anything else? What if we went this way? Would that change anything?
No.
So we'd have 1, 2, 3, 4 if we went like this, and we would still have 4-methyl and 4-propyl because we'd have 1, 2, 3, that'd be a 3-carbon chain there. So we would still have 4, 4, and then 5. Anybody else want to make a suggestion? Anyone see anything else? But if you do, let me know and we'll correct it. Okay, folks, so then what do we move on to?
Naming,
yes. And like I said, you're going to want to do 4-4-5, but a UPAC says ha 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 ha. You have to do alphabetization. And so that means that we're going to say who is first in the alphabet. M, P, or
B.
B. Why B? Why not T? Because IUPAC said this. When you have something that is hyphenated, you're gonna ignore that. Ah! Right, friends? Yes, yes. I'm looking at the B. Okay, somebody tell me who comes first. Yes, so we have the 5-T-butyl, and again, that's because of the B in the butyl. And then what?
4-propyl. 4-methyl,
and again, you don't do 4-4-methyl-propyl because those two things are different, so we're going to split them up. So you have 4-methyl, and then what, folks?
4-propyl,
what?
Octane.
Okay, now can you see why those ingredients in your shampoo and conditioner have such long names? Yeah, because you're naming this molecule that you're throwing in there, and you gotta say what that branch is, where it is, and what the apparent name is. Okay, questions for me, folks? We're all right? Okay, moving on. So let's draw, because for most of us, drawing is going to be easier than naming. Okay, so notice there's a couple of things here that we haven't learned yet, like bromo, chloro, and fluoro. So we're used to going from methane to methyl or ethane to ethyl, but what on earth is bromo and chloro? It just means that it's the bromine atom that's on a molecule. So if you have a bromine atom and you plop it onto a molecule, the name goes to bromo. And if you have a chlorine atom on a molecule, the name goes to chloro. And fluorine goes to what?
Fluoro.
And iodine goes to what?
Iodo,
which sounds
sounds really weird, right? Okay, so it's not a big deal. It's just the halogens, which go in the halogenated waste instead of the non-halogenated waste, for those of us who did Monday lab and encountered the different types of waste. Okay, so where we're gonna start when we draw a molecule is with the parent chain. So we've got heptane. How many carbons is that, folks?
Seven.
And me, I always like to draw the skeletal structures because it's easiest. You don't have to draw in all of those hydrogens. And for students, then you don't make hydrogen mistakes that get you missing points, right? Is there one hydrogen there? Is there two? Is there three? Ah! All right. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And go ahead and count for yourselves again, because a common student mistake is to add in one extra carbon when doing the line bond structure. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And you could have drawn that upside down or like this or like that. Yeah. All right, folks. So we did our heptane. And then it says 2-bromo and 2-methyl, because we have 2,3,4-trimethyl there. So what am I going to put on my second carbon here? And I'm assuming we're going to number left to right. If you wanted to be fancy and say, oh no, carbon 2 will be here. Is that okay?
Yes.
Absolutely. It's your drawing. Okay. So what goes here?
Bromine.
A bromine and what else? A methyl group. And a methyl looks like what in our skeletal structure? It just looks like a line. So you just stick a little stick up there like that. You could have put it that way. That's fine. What you don't want to do is you don't want to put it down like that. That's not technically wrong. It's just convention is if the mountain is pointing up, you put the stuff up. If it's down, you put them down. Okie dokie smokies. All right. Now, if we put another stick there, that would mean that there was another methyl there. So you're going to want to make sure you put that other thing there, which you guys already told me is a what? Is a bromine. Now, I could have put the bromine on the left stick or the right stick. Doesn't matter. Okie dokie smokies. All right. So we have done our 2-bromo, we have done our heptane, and we have done our 2-methyl. Okay, on to carbon number 3. What goes on carbon number 3?
Chlorine.
A chlorine and a what? And a methyl group. And I just leave it like that. And yes, I could have drawn the chlorine on the right and put the methyl on the left. That would be fine too. Okay, folks, what else?
The fluoro.
Yeah, okay, so the fluoro and the final methyl, right? Okay, so let's go ahead and put the methyl on there, and let's put the fluoro on there. Any questions for me? Not too bad? Do you see how drawing's a little easier than naming?
Yes.
Yeah, because the whole answer is there for you. You just have to like put the pieces together. Okay. Was that a question back there, or is that? Okay, all right, let's move on. Okay, 10 says that the numbering of different groups is not resolved. The first sided group gets the lower number. Okay, so let me number this chain for you, folks. So in the first scenario, we would have 3-methyl and what else with the blue numbering, folks?
5-ethyl.
Okay, so that's going to give us a 3-5 situation. And pretend that the answer is not already there for you, okay? And in the red numbering system, we're going to have 3-ethyl and what?
5-methyl.
So again, that gives us a 3 and a 5. 3, 5, 3, 5. So there's no point of difference in the numbering system.
So do you guys see that? So before, when we had a few branches, we numbered the way that would give us the lowest number at the first point of difference. But there's no point of difference here. So IUPAC says if you come upon a situation like that, then you're going to default to the alphabetization. And you're going to put the E before the M. Okay, so that means that the ethyl gets the 3 and the methyl gets the 5 because you have to decide something and that's the rule they made. Okay, folks? Okay, because we could do 3-methyl, 5-ethyl and still have the same numbering, but let's do it that way. So what we get, folks, is 3-ethyl, 5-methyl heptene. Questions for me? Okay, so that's a special case. So if the numbering were to be lower or there was a point of difference, obviously you wouldn't go, oh, ethyl comes first, so I'll just give that the lower number. All right, you gotta follow the rules, that's a special case.
What's the answer?
The answer is right here. So we've got the red ones. Is that clear, folks? So we have 3-ethyl, 5-methyl heptene. Okay, some highly condensed structures that you folks might see, just so you're familiar with the fact that we write things a bazillion different ways and just expect you guys to know, oh, that's the same thing as that one. So if we have something like this and someone's trying to save some space, they might write it like this. So they're saying that I've got a central carbon that's bonded to 4 CH3s. All right, and again, H3C, same thing as CH3. Or maybe it's flipped like that because the person's just like, ha 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 ha, I want to write this differently. This one down here, we've got a couple of OHs on that molecule. We'll get to OHs, which make something an alcohol, in chapter 15 it is, I believe. So the next chapter, we're going to do double bonds and triple bonds, and then we'll move on to alcohols, which is always fun, right, folks? Especially on the weekends. Yes. All right, so let's do classification of carbons, which is usually the part of the chapter that students find the easiest. It'd be like, please put 30 of these on the exam. Okay, so a primary carbon. So that has a 1 and then a degree symbol for primary. This is a carbon that is bonded to only one other carbon. And if you have a carbon that's bonded to only one other carbon, then you're going to be bonded to how many hydrogens? 3, and that's these guys in here. So those are terminal carbons. So this is bonded to only one other carbon and it's bonded to 3 hydrogens. That's gonna be your primary carbon on all of the ends. Now a secondary carbon is gonna be a carbon that's bonded to 2 other carbons. And if it's bonded to 2 other carbons, then it's probably bonded to how many hydrogens? 2, because we're used to carbons liking 4 single bonds. And if 2 of them are already taken up to with bonding to other carbons, then that leaves 2 bonds for our hydrogens. A tertiary carbon, carbon bonded to 3 other carbons, and probably how many hydrogens? 1. So bonded to 1, 2, 3 carbons, and that leaves room for just that 1 hydrogen right there. A quaternary carbon is going to be bonded to 4 other carbons, which leaves room for how many hydrogens to be bonded to it?
0.
None. 0. And we can see our quaternary carbon right here. Questions for me, folks? Do you think on the test we can just identify stuff? I'm like, which one of these carbons is a tertiary carbon? You guys can maybe be like, oh, it's that one right there. Just not today, right? Okay. So that brings us to classification of hydrogens. Now, this is really easy because if you are a hydrogen that's bonded to a primary carbon, you are a primary hydrogen. If you are a
that's bonded to a secondary carbon. You are what kind of hydrogen? You are a secondary hydrogen. If you are a tertiary carbon and you have a hydrogen bonded to you, that hydrogen is what kind of hydrogen? A tertiary hydrogen. If you are a quaternary carbon, what kind of hydrogen do you have bonded to you? No kind of hydrogen, right? Right, folks? There's no room to bond to a hydrogen there if you're a quaternary carbon. Right, folks? That's why it's not there, okay? There's nothing that says a quaternary hydrogen up there. Are we okay with that? Counselor, maybe? Okay, it's nap time, hurry up. Okay, so let's locate the primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary carbons in this big old molecule. So folks, the ones on the ends are gonna be what? To those primary carbons are what kind of hydrogens? They would be primary hydrogens. Are we all right with that? Okay, so then we might want to locate all of our secondary carbons, and those are going to be the ones that have carbons that if we drew in all of the hydrogens, we'd see CH2, CH2, CH2. Does that make sense, folks? Yes, no, maybe so. Okay. So we've got secondary there, and there, and there. What about the next one? No, because that carbon right there, that green one, is bonded to how many other carbons? Three. So that one right there is tertiary, right, folks? Okay, so we'll go, that one's tertiary. And the next one to the right of the tertiary carbon, is that secondary?
Mm-hmm.
Sure is. What about the one to the right of the one we did?
Tertiary.
No, that one is what? Tertiary. Are we okay with this? Okay, so more secondaries. Do we have more secondaries, folks? How about this one right here? Any more? Yes, where?
On the purple.
On the purple, so up here. That's a lot of arrows going everywhere, huh? Okay, any other secondaries? Any tertiaries that we forgot? Any quaternaries? Yes, no, maybe so, folks? Okay, so our quaternary carbons, that one right there, is there another one? How about that one right there? Yeah? Did we miss any? So we're good? Questions for me, folks? Okay. Anyone need the slides still? All right, let's shift over to cycloalkenes. So our cycloalkenes are gonna have a cyclic structure. So as you can see, these aren't a straight chain. We take the ends and we bond them together. And when we do that, what we're gonna need to do is take hydrogens off of the end, because if we have a long hydrocarbon chain and we have CH3s on the end, they can't bond to anything else. So if we pull hydrogens off the end, the ones on the end would then be CH2s, and they could bond to something else and wrap it around and bond them to each other. And this means that we come to this rule right here. Our cycloalkenes are going to have two fewer hydrogens than our regular old alkenes. So what we do is we count up the carbons in order to name them. So with this one right here, we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And usually when we have six carbons, that chain is called what? Hexane. It's right there at the bottom there. It's usually called hexane. But because this is a cyclic structure, we're going to plop what at the front?
Cyclo.
So instead of hexane, this is a cyclohexane. And looking at this, you folks can see that we've got the full structural formula here. We've got the condensed formula here, and we have the line bond formula right there. Now notice that you don't draw the hydrogens into the ring. And you don't do that because the hydrogens don't go into the ring. That would take up a lot of space in there and cause a lot of tension in the molecule. And the molecule would be like, no, flip it to the outside. So right here, you can see that on this side, we're going to put H2C just to emphasize that the hydrogens aren't going into it. Are you folks okay with this? Kind of, sort of, maybe? Notice how there's no CH3s there in the ring? Okay, good, good. Questions for me? Okay, so the nomenclature rules for cycloalkenes is going to be the same as for our regular alkenes, except we're going to have cyclo in there. So if we're looking at this one right here, we would identify the longest continuous chain, which would be this one right here. If I wanted to include this one right here, I would go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but IUPAC says, no, you don't do that. You just look at that ring and then you look at the branches that are on the ring, okay? So that's a little bit of difference there. So for this one right here, our parent chain is gonna be cyclobutane, and we've got a methyl hanging off of it. Now notice how there's no number here. Why is there no number there? When we don't see a number, we usually assume it's what?
One.
So this is 1-methylcyclobutane. And it's 1-methylcyclobutane because there's only one branch on the parent chain. And you want to keep the number as low as possible, so you wouldn't call it 2-methylcyclobutane. Does that make sense? Okay. But if it's a number other than one, you have to put it there. And we'll see that when we get right here. So you have the 1,3-dimethylcyclobutane. So one of them is gonna be on the first carbon and the other one is gonna be on the third carbon because it will be 1, 2, 3. And does it matter if this one is carbon 1 and that one is carbon 3 or this one is carbon 1 and that one is carbon 3 for this molecule? No, it's a 1,3-dimethyl, either way you go. But you wouldn't want to do 1, 2, 3, 4 and have a 2,4-dimethyl because 2,4, those numbers are higher than 1,3. Does that make sense, folks? Are we okay with why we numbered it that way? Okay, so this one over here on the end, this is gonna be cyclohexane because the cyclic structure has six carbons. So we've got a methyl and an ethyl. Now C2H5, you guys are used to it being CH2CH3. This is just writing it in a different format, okay? So we've got methyl here and we've got ethyl here. And to number this, you're gonna wanna do 1,2 or 1,2. Either way, we would have the numbers 1,2 and there's no point of difference. But we saw with IUPAC that the rule says if you have the same numbering, you have to choose to number one way or the other. You have to choose to give either the methyl or the ethyl number one. And they said that you go ahead and go with which one? Don't cheat. You go with the ethyl because why?
E comes first.
E comes before M. Okay? So we go ahead and we go 1, 2. So we have 1-ethyl-2-methylcyclohexane.
Okie dokie, smokies? Yes, I hope so.
Okay, so looking at the example at the bottom, notice that your cyclic structure has 3 carbons. So 1, 2, 3. Your straight chain right here has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons. Now, if the straight chain is longer than the cyclic structure, you go with the straight chain for being the parent, and you call the cyclic structure the branch. So the name of the cyclic structure will have its ending changed. So if you just have the triangle on its own, that would be called cyclo-what? Cyclopropane. Things with 3 carbons tend to be called something with a prop or propan in them, all right? So usually when we have propane and it becomes a branch, we switch it from propane to what? Propyl. So if you have a cyclopropane and it is now a branch, then its name becomes what? Cyclopropyl. Is that okay with us? Yes, no, maybe so?
Yeah.
Okay. So then the question is, if this is the parent right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that one right there is the branch, how do we number this? Are we going to number it left to right or right to left? Right to left, because we want that branch on the lowest number possible. Right, folks? Okay, so we want to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rather than 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 because we want a 1-cyclopropyl rather than a 5-cyclopropyl. Are we making sense here? Yes, no, maybe so? Okay, so then we're going to have 1-cyclopropyl pentane. Not pentyl cyclopropane. So the bottom one right here is assuming that you made that into the branch. Instead of pentane, you called it pentyl and then made that the parent. You don't want to do that. So we don't want to number it like that. And we also don't want to put the pentane chain as the substituent. Now the other question is, like, why can't we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 like that? Because I'm not picking up my pencil. Well, it's a different situation because then you would be calling it octane. And it's not the same as octane as a straight chain. So you have to make the cyclic structure in this molecule known in order for whoever's reading your name to be able to picture, like, oh, okay, I know which molecule this person is talking about. Okie dokie, smokies? We're all right with this? Kind of, sort of, maybe? Yes, no? So that one right there, if you just put cyclopropyl pentane, you would assume it was a 1-cyclopropyl pentane. But because you have this special situation where it's the cyclic structure is a branch and it's hanging off the end rather than at the 2 position, then they just emphasized it. That makes sense? Okay. So if this one up here, if you said 1-methylcyclobutane, that's not wrong. Convention says you just don't usually say that. Okay? Okay, so let's name some. Does anyone want to do the squirmy looking guy there? In the back, go right ahead.
If you, we would
sometimes is like, oh, that's wrong, and doesn't realize that
yeah.
that's technically right. So just be aware of that glitch there.
But if it was a handwritten test, though.
Oh, I would not mark it wrong now.
Okay.
Absolutely not. Do you want to try this one? Let's just start numbering the cyclic structure where the straight chain's hanging on, because that's going to be carbon number one. So we'll do one, and then does it matter if I go clockwise or counterclockwise, folks?
No,
because there's not another branch hanging off of that cyclic structure there, so we don't have to keep the numbers as low as possible because we only have number one. So if we want to do this way, that is... Oh, I did one twice. Thank you for catching that. Apparently, I don't know how to number today. Did I do it again? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No? I learned my numbers in kindergarten this time.
You just forgot it.
I missed one? Oh, 8. I just forgot 8. I'm trying not to embarrass myself and be like, okay, you guys, I need to do this. Okay. All right. So what is the parent there, folks? So we've got cyclo-what? Octane. So we have cyclo-octane, not cyclutane. What's our branch? So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons there. And my friend right here said butane. But it's a branch, so it's going to be called what? Yeah, butyl. Butyl. Okay, and I drew those red carbons in because I wanted you guys to see that you don't include the carbon of the cyclic structure there. That's part of the parent. Okay, so putting those things together, what would we call it?
One butyl cyclooctane
or just butyl cyclooctane? Because if you only have one branch on your cyclic structure, it has to be on which carbon of the cyclic structure? It has to be on carbon number one. Because you have to keep the numbers as low as possible. So if you have one branch, it's on carbon number one.
The branch always goes first, right?
Yes. So you could call it one butyl cyclooctane. We just don't usually do that. Okay, folks, does anyone want to try the next one? Which is bigger then?
Are they the same size?
They're the same. Yeah, they're the same size. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons in the cyclic structure here. And this carbon belongs to the cyclic structure, not to the straight chain. The straight chain starts right there. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 also. Do you guys see that? Okay, so let me just put those in red and blue. Okay, and obviously there's hydrogens on there. I just want to draw all the hydrogens. So can we see that both of them have 4 carbons? Okay. So IUPAC says if you have this situation where you have 4 and 4, that the cyclic structure takes precedence for being the parent. Because you have to make a choice. And IUPAC says this is a choice you will make if you would like points on your test. Right, folks?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So the parent is cyclo what?
Butane.
It's cyclobutane. So our parent... I guess I should write that in red so it corresponds. Our parent is going to be cyclobutane. And again, you do not have to write this down for yourself. I'm just putting my thought process on the screen. And the branch is going to be what?
Butyl.
Butyl. how do we put that together?
Butyl cyclobutane.
And you can put one butyl cyclobutane, but you don't need to. And we don't usually. Are we okay with that? Yes, no, maybe so? Okay, so let's do the chicken looking thing at the bottom there.
So, the cyclic structure right here, the cyclohexane, is going to be the parent. Is everybody okay with that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So then we have four branches coming off of this one. So we have to figure out how to name this. Now, where do you guys want to put the one, first of all?
No.
You
want to
do one here?
Bottom left.
This one or this one? This one?
Yeah.
Okay, so we have one and then we would go two, two? Okay, so if you did that, you'd have one, two, two. But what if we put the one right here? Then you'd have one, one. Does that sound lower, folks? So my friend in the front, she said she wants to go one, two, three, four. So let's number it that way and we'll see what we have there. So one, two, three, four. So we would have a one, two, two, four. If we go one and then two, we'd have one, one, two, five. But right here is the first point of difference. So a lot of us would do this and be like, oh, the five. No, I don't want the five there. But IUPAC says when you come to the first point of difference, that's where you choose. So the 1-1 situation is going to keep the numbers at the first point of difference lower than the 1-2-2. Are we okay with that, folks?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's why we're going to choose that. Now, if we went this way, we'd have a 1-1-1-1-3, and so that would be 1-1-3, and we'd go here, and we'd go, okay, the 2 is less than the 3, and we'd still pick that same one. Was anyone thinking that, maybe? Are we okay with this? You guys are like, just get on with it, please. Okay, so we have our parents, which is, what did we say? What did we decide on that one? Cyclohexane. And our branches. We've got 1,1 dimethyl. Is everybody okay with that?
Yes.
All right. And at number two, what do we have there? Yes, because you have 1, 2, 3 carbons right there. And again, you do not want to include the carbon that's part of the cyclic structure because that's part of the parent chain. So we've got a regular old propyl there. Okay. And then on carbon number 5, folks, what do you have? That's an isopropyl. Good. Like a little snake tongue there. Okay, so then we have to assemble this. So we figured out what the parent chain was, we figured out what the numbering system is, and now we have to assemble the name. And IUPAC says you're gonna go ahead and go with alphabetization, not putting the numbers in order necessarily. So then we're gonna look at D or M in dimethyl.
M.
You're gonna look at the M. Because IUPAC said the rule is you ignore the Greek prefixes di, tri, and tetra. Now in propyl, what do we look at? The P, that one's a standard one. What about isopropyl? You do look at the I. You don't ignore it like you ignored the D for di, because it's not a Greek prefix like di, tri, and tetra, and it's not hyphenated. So we saw that back here.
how this is death by a million rules?
Yeah.
Don't worry though, at the end of the semester you will have it down. You'll be reading those shampoo bottles with ease. Like, I know what that looks like. Okay, so back to this slide. Okay, folks, so who's coming first in this name? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Five isopropyl, even though five is the biggest number and you want to put one first.
Nope.
Okay, so we've got five isopropyl what? Thank you, 1,1-dimethyl. Keep going for me. 2-propyl, what? Cyclohexane. Look at that name. Took up the whole screen space. Now you guys see why those names are so long, right? Yay, if you learn anything in this class, it's to read the shampoo bottle, right? Questions for me? Besides, is she going to take the next 9 minutes? Okay, last slide of this chapter. Yay! And it's drawing. So we've got draw 2-cyclopropylheptane. So the parent is what? Heptane. That's just a normal heptane. There's no cyclo there. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What am I going to draw in carbon number 2? A cyclopropyl. And that is just a cyclopropane that's hanging off a bigger molecule, right, folks? Okay, so I go to carbon number 2, and then I go up and I draw myself a little triangle like that. Okay, so the carbons of the heptane are the blue carbons. The carbons of the cyclopropyl are the red carbons. So don't include, again, don't include the carbon of the parent chain because it belongs to the parent chain. Are you guys okay with that? Questions? Concerns? Yes, sir.
So that one has to, so the one that you form a triangle, that cyclopropyl.
That's cyclopropyl. Folks, on quizzes and exams, don't draw those carbons in. I'm just drawing them in so you can see where they're at. So in a line bond structures, we don't draw our atoms in, unless they're not carbons and hydrogens. Like if it's a bromine, yes, you definitely put it there. Okay, so we want to draw T-butyl cyclopentane. So cyclopentane, folks, is going to have how many carbons?
Five.
That pent part of it tells you five, and it's a cyclic structure. So we're gonna go ahead and draw a pentagon. So is everybody okay with the fact that that is cyclopentane? Okay, and then we've got T-butyl right there. What does T-butyl look like? A T! So this is gonna look like a church because most of us will stick the cross right there on the top. If you want it to be fancy and stick it on the bottom or the side, fine, that would still be T-butyl cyclopentane. Are you guys okay with this?
Yes.
Okay. D, 2-bromo-1,1-dimethylcyclobutane. What does cyclobutane look like? A square, yep. So we've got a square here. And it says 1,1-dimethyl. Does it matter where I put those two methyls? Nope. Doesn't matter because you're making the drawing, so you get to decide where the first carbon is in the cyclic structure. If it was a straight chain, you'd have to stick it on the end, but it's cyclic, so you can put it anywhere. So let's be different and let's stick it at the bottom left because most of us would put it on the top. Now, does it matter where you put that bromine? It does matter. You have some choices, but it does matter. So can I put the bromine off of this carbon? Yep, how about this one?
Yes.
How about this one?
Okay.
No, because that would be 1,1,3. So you want to keep it as 1,1,2 or 1,1,2. Does that make sense, folks?
Mm-hmm.
So we'll stick the bromine off the bottom over here just to be different. Now, one thing I want to point out to you, is there something else bonded to that carbon that you don't see? Yeah, there's a hydrogen there. So just in case you forgot, carbons like to have four single bonds. So there's a hydrogen there that you don't see. We just don't draw the hydrogens on our skeletal structures. We assume that you know that they're there. So there you go.
Did you close the triangle on B, like the cyclopropylheptane? Did you close it because it's cyclo?
Did I
like the snake on top for number the first one? Did you close the triangle because
it's
cyclo?
Yes.
Oh.
So if it was propyl, it would just be like, yeah. Questions for me, folks? Well, I thought we were gonna get into chapter 13, but I guess not. So I will leave there. And we will do chapter 13 next time we meet. Those of you who have lab, please bring your goggles because we are doing a real experiment today. And yes, sir. What's that?
Is there school on Monday?
Is there school on Monday? I think we have a holiday. Yeah. Labor Day is next week, not the week after, right?
No.
Okay, all right. Oh, I'm sorry. Okay, folks, that's all I have for you today. Don't forget to take your quiz. The quiz is figuring out the lockdown browser code. Okay, that's the assignment. Figure it out with the directions I gave you. Okay.
Yes. Where can I find the other answers?
They should be in the lecture assignments module. There's a link to it. Click it, and there it is. If it's not there, email me and let me know.
Okay. Because I looked for it, I couldn't find it, but I'll look at it.
Okay. Lecture assignments module is where I usually put it.
So just pick modules and then.
Yeah, either for week one or week two. But I'm pretty sure for this chapter it should be in week one.
Okay.
If it's not there, let me know. I'll put it there.
Okay. Sounds good.
Yes, ma'am.
Just the quiz.
Assignments.
module?
Just first,
yeah, and then
okay.
We only
and
have
and
one,
if you have
one
trouble finding
midterm
just
one,
let me
midterm
know.
Two, and
okay.
I don't
I have
know. The three
here,
yeah. That's it, yeah.
I'll
be happy with the B though too.
Okay.
This shit's hard.
Yes. So
I'm not gonna lie, this shit's hard.
Yeah,
I don't think
right there.
Okay.
I doubt it.
Okay, thank you.
You're very welcome.
Have a nice day. Survival
mode. Yeah, but that's why I didn't want to be like that the whole like the same being survival mode.
Oh my god.
Yeah,
first
so I do have goggles, but I
did
forget them. Would you like me to go buy new ones?
No, I have some extras.
Okay. Yeah, I'm like I'll bring you next time.
I don't guarantee that they're not like well like that.
No, that's fine.
Okay.
Yeah, I like, had two doctor's appointments today.
Oh,
I had to go.
Perfect. It's
my birthday, dude.
Oh, your birthday today?
Yeah, that's my birthday.
Oh, happy birthday.
Thank you, appreciate it.
Enjoy the rest of it, okay?
Thank you. Have a good one.
It's my birthday, too. That's kind of neat.
No, it's your birthday, too.
It is.
Happy birthday.
No, it's not.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, and they have librarian. That's her birthday, too.
It's everybody's birthday.
That is so crazy, because I live my whole life meeting nobody that has my same birthday, and then. Wow.
Same, and you know what? As I've grown older, I have met more people. I'm like, whoa, it's
right?
Insane.
Yeah.
Well, hey, Mrs. Gray.
Yeah.
Yes,
so
I'm listening.
Class on Monday then?
If it's a holiday,